everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. My name is Maggie. Today I'm giving you an update on my rolling project 10-ish pan for 2021. So in the beginning of 21, I decided I'm going to pick 10 items to kind of work on. My rules are pretty simple. Once I finish something, I will roll something else in. Doesn't have to be like category for category, but I'm not forcing myself to always have 10 products in at a time. For example, I started with 10, and then in February I had 9 items that I'm working on. In March I'm going to have 11, so it's just kind of hovering around that 10-ish mark because I have a pretty small makeup collection, so I'm just worried about later in the year if there's times where I'm like, I just don't have 10 things that I really want to be working on. I don't have to hold myself to 10. So with all that being said, let's dive into my update. I did hit my goal on 2 items, so I will be rolling some things in at the end of the video. But first, let me give you an update on how I'm doing with all the products, which ones I finished, and then we'll get into the new stuff. So I'm going to start with the items that I've had in since January, and the first 2 are lip products, and I have the combo on my lips today. So the lip liner that I'm working on is from Jordana. It is the easy liner for lips in the shade Tawny. This is a discontinued product, and this is how much I have left, not like a ton, but you know, a decent amount. So I do track this on a sheet of paper. So for the lip liner, that is where I am. So the third line at the bottom there is where I'm currently at. So I have a little bit left. I will say I just got back from a work trip. I was gone for 10 days in total, like from my home. So I packed some of these, but like a lip liner and lipstick, I was wearing a mask the whole time. So I didn't really wear lipstick or lip liner. I just wore my chapstick. So these 2 definitely could have had more progress, but my life kind of threw a wrench in that, but that's okay. The lipstick I still have going as well. This is from Ulta Beauty brand. It's in the shade Nude, and it's just a perfect My Lips But Better type lipstick. So I do have a little bit left there. I mean, it's kind of down to that nubbin phase. So I will be focusing on this quite a bit in the next month to see if I can finish it off. It's very comfortable to wear. It's a cream type formula, so I find it easy to wear throughout the day, even if I'm not wearing like a full face of makeup, because it's a My Lips But Better type shade, it works. So for the lipstick, my progress is tracked right here. So it is that bottom blue line that I'm currently at. So those 2 have been in since January. I'm hoping to have one of them finished up before my April update, but we'll see. I'm not really sure which one of these 2. I mean, both would be great. Last time I was like, oh yeah, I'll have these done, but LOL, joke's on me. Okay, other items that have been in since January is a setting spray. I'm looking at my laptop. I have the list there, so apologies. This is from Wet n Wild, the Rose Photo Focus Setting Spray. I did finish this bad boy up. So at the beginning of January, this was new. At my February update, I was at this line here, and I finished this much up. So I do use this as a setting spray, but I also use a spray of this on the back of my hand, and then I use a flat liner brush with an eyeshadow to do my eyeliner. I do prefer having my brush wet when I do the eyeliner, so usually I would rather just use my setting spray than get up and like wet the brush at the sink, because it's, you know, a time thing. So I was able to use this in both those ways, and I feel like that's part of the way I was able to go through this pretty quick. This was only 1.52 fluid ounces as well, so it's not like the biggest setting spray there ever was, but I'm happy to be done with it. Okay, I've also been working on a foundation. This is my CoverFX Power Play foundation. I have it upside down because it is a squeezy tube type bottle here. So I'm at the bottom of it. I believe the packaging itself is actually tinted this color because I'm not seeing any sort of gaps in there, but I know that this is almost empty. I have the shade N10, which is my winter shade, but yeah, I really like it. I have it on today. I just did a get ready with me actually, so I will have that posted a little bit later this week. Not out yet. But yeah, I'm almost done with this. It's getting really hard to squeeze. So when I'm at the point where I can't squeeze out anymore, I'll consider it done. So I do think that this will be done before next update. I'm usually just wearing foundation maybe like 2, 3 times a week, not every day. But even with that kind of usage, I feel like this will be done next month. So I'll be happy to get that out because it is, again, my winter shade. And we are thankfully moving into spring and summer soon. Okay, another product I've had in since January is my Milk Makeup Highlighter Stick. This is the holographic stick, I should say. So it kind of has like a purpley, like hint to it. I am doing a usage goal. I'd like to use this 30 times. And I just keep a little sticky note of my project pan items, specifically with this one, so I can tally as I use it. So at my first update, I used this 10 times. Since then, I have used it 6 times. So I'm at 16 total uses. So I have 14 to go. I'm over halfway. And I think that I can do it. I don't know if I'll have that done before next month or not. I do enjoy this product, but I also have a few other highlighters that I like to play with too. So I'm okay if this, takes a couple of months. I would like to have this done maybe and roll out of the project, not like finished. Maybe in like 2 months-ish. So if I only have, what I say, 14, so then I would only have to use it 7 times next month and 7 times the month after. But we'll just see. Again, I do have it on today, so if you're seeing any kind of like purple on my cheeks, it's this product. It's beautiful and lovely, and I really like it. So working through that still. Okay, and then the last item from my project that is original from January is an eyeshadow out of my Anastasia Sultry palette. So the shadow in here that I'm working on is the shade Pearl, which is this really kind of shimmery champagne shade. As you can see, I do have pan in there. So this shadow is one that I'm trying to finish by the end of the year. I've been using it as my designated inner corner highlight shade. I also like it on the lid, but I think it's kind of a lot for the lid sometimes. So inner corner, I know I can at least use this each time I do my eye makeup without a question. Now, I did not bring this palette with me on my work trip, so I wasn't using it for about 10 days this past month, but I don't think it really would have made that much of a difference because my goal is to finish it and I already have pan on it. So we'll see where I get. I think this is going to be one that's in for the long haul, but that's okay with me. I just would like to finish it up, and I know that using it on the inner corner doesn't use that much product, so I'll probably have to use it on my lid a little bit more to make some significant progress, but I'm still pleased with it and don't really like mind using it. So let's move into the items that I put into this in February. And I do have another shadow from this palette, so we'll just roll right into there. The shadow that I put in February, I actually put two in. So the first one is Cinder. Cinder is right down here. And my goal is to hit pan on Cinder. I do have this all over my lids today as like my shimmery lid shade. I do like it that way, and I also like it on the lower lash line or like the outer third if I'm doing maybe a more golden or a lighter lid look. This is great for like a medium deeping up type situation. I do think I can hit pan next month. I thought I was gonna hit pan today. I didn't, but it's pretty down there, the dip at least, so I feel good about it. I'm not super worried. And yeah, once I hit pan on that, I'll probably move to Teak. Because I feel like those two are pretty similar, at least when they're on my eyes. I can't tell too much of a difference. So I just, yeah, started with Cinder, and then I'll probably just move into Teak next and use it that way. The other shadow from this palette that I rolled in is the shade Dystopian. So it's this dark brown, and I'm using this as a liner. So I previously was using Noir, which you can see I have some pan in, so I decided to move into the chocolate brown. You can definitely tell where I put my brush. I, again, am using this flat liner brush with the setting spray, and I kind of dig in there to get the product lifted onto the brush so that I can draw it onto my eyes. So I don't know. I feel like I've got a couple more months left in Dystopian. I'm not using it every single time I use eyeshadow. Sometimes I do want a black liner instead of brown. So that is kind of the disadvantage to Dystopian, is that it is that chocolate brown, and sometimes it's just not quite deep enough for me. But I do like having a dedicated liner shade, again, where if I don't feel like it matters if I use black or brown, then I know that this is the one I'm going to be using. I did roll in a similar dark brown shade in my eyeshadow roulette, but that's kind of the beauty of my eyeshadow roulette project is that each month I re-roll for different shades, and my goal for that is just to use it maybe like 5 times. So I don't think that's going to be that big of a deal having 2 chocolate browns in that I'm working on at this point in time because this is still my primary focus. That one's just kind of like for fun and on the side. So as a recap, the 3 shades that I'm working on in here, I'm not adding anymore, is Pearl, Cinder, and Dystopian. So we've covered those. Let's talk about the cream eyeshadow I was working on this past month. So that one came from my ColourPop Bare Necessities palette. This year, my goal is to work through and hit pan on all of the cream shades that I would use to set my primer. So I was working on the shade In the Buff, which is right here, and I did hit some pan. So there's that. I did not keep track of how many times I used it, unfortunately. I probably will going forward when I add new eyeshadows in, I'll try to keep track of them. But I did hit pan on this on the 5th of March. So just recently, but it was right before my trip, which was nice. So I did not bring this with me because I already hit my goal on it. And then I did already know which next shade I was going to work on for my cream shadows and just rolled right into that. So with that being said, I did hit the goal of 2 products this past month, and I'm going to be rolling in 4 new items. So let's talk about what those are. I want to start with the eyeshadows because that's what I was just talking about. So I said that I finished up hitting pan in this palette and went right into the next one that I want to work on, and that is from my Anastasia Soft Glam 2 palette. So it's like the mini version of the Soft Glam palette. I really love this. This is the only palette I brought with me on my work trip, so it made sense for me to just start working on Tempera, which is this shade right here. It is not matte, it's more of like a satin, but it still works the same way for me. It doesn't really matter that it's a satin or a matte. I'm just looking for something kind of close to my skin tone that will set my primer and allow for my shadows to blend nicely on top of them. So I do have a decent dip in here. I'm not sure if you're gonna really be able to tell or not. Hopefully, I'm just gonna kind of move this around. I have used this, I did start keep track, a total of 8 times so far, and I feel like I'm close to hitting pan. These pans in this mini palette are not very big. They are 0.8 grams, so not even a full gram. And because I use this every single day, I feel like I'm gonna be able to hit pan before my next update. So, I'm going to prematurely bring in another cream type shade that once I do hit pan on this one, I can go right into the next one. So, this is kind of like a bonus, but I just feel like I'm gonna hit pan on that pretty soon and I'll just wanna roll right into the next one. So, the next cream type shade I'm going to work from is out of my ColourPop Wild Nothing palette. This is a newer palette to me. I got this at the end of January. And the shade in here that I would use in the same manner is the first one called Crystal Cove. So it's kind of a beige cream, and it does have like some glitter in it. It's one of those kind of like a sequin shadows where it's matte but it has glitter. For me, if I use that and I tap off my brush, I can usually get a lot of the glitter off. I don't mind if there's glitter all over my eyes because I usually always use a shimmery eyeshadow across my lid anyway, so I don't really care. I'm also working from home, so the chances that someone through Zoom, through my glasses, is gonna be like, oh, you have glitter on your eyes. Like, no one's gonna say that to me. So, yeah, this is going to be the one that I try to hit pan on next. I don't know if I'll have this one with pan in it before my next update, but I feel very confident that this one's going to go soon. So, I just wanna have this one ready to go. You guys would already know about it. So, those are 2 of the 4 items that I'm rolling in. The other 2 items that I'm rolling in, one is a blush and one's a lip product. So let's start with the blush. The blush that I'm bringing in is my Hourglass Mood Exposure Blush. I worked on this all last year. I love this blush. And this is the mini size, I guess I forgot to say that. And this is all that I have left. So I've already hit significant amount of pan. I have a little bit in these corners, a little bit more on this side, but I don't have much left. And every time I use this, I see even more pan. So I feel like this is going to be something that I can definitely use up within the next couple of months as my kind of go-to blush. I have a few other blushes that I'd like to play with, so probably won't use this every single day, but I definitely think that with the amounts in here, it's doable for me to believe that I can finish it up. But it's just a really beautiful kind of rosy shade. I do have it on today, but I have like a lot of highlight on too, so I'm not sure if you can really tell, but I would totally repurchase this. I love this blush. I would only ever get the mini size because, again, this took me like probably at the end of the day, it would probably take me like 2 years to actually use it up, but I really focused on it last year. So really, really love this, and I just want to make sure that it, you know, hits the graveyard one day and I can repurchase a fresh one. And then the last item that I'm going to roll in is a lip product. This is from Bare Minerals. It's a liquid lipstick, and this is in the shade Boss. As you can see, I have used quite a bit of this. There's a lot of windows in the product already, and this is definitely like pretty empty. So my goal is to use this 15 times, and then I'll roll it out. This is also on my list of things that I set all my own expirations for my makeup. So for my comfort level, anything that's not a powder, so any sort of cream or liquid, I would like it out of my collection in 3 years from when I like bought it. So I need to either use it or declutter it. But after 3 years, like, I don't want to use it on my face anymore. So this does need to be out of my collection by the end of 2021. So I want to use it 15 times, see how far it goes, see how it wears, how it lasts, and then decide if it's worth still keeping in for me to use throughout the rest of the year or if it's just kind of time for it to go. So 15 uses is my goal here. Now I do have this other lipstick that I'm working on. This one's a little bit darker. I can give you a swatch so you can see. So this one pulls a little bit darker than the lipstick. So the lipstick's down here and the liquid lip is up top, but they're pretty similar in tone. So I feel like what I'll probably end up doing is wearing this one maybe for filming or like on the weekend, and this one more day to day throughout the week because it's pretty comfortable and I can easily reapply it throughout the day. So I think that's my plan, but like I said, 15 uses. I'm not trying to get all 15 before my next update. It probably will be more like 5-ish a month, and it'll take me maybe 3 months to work through that 15 goal. But yeah, that is going to be added in, and they're pretty similar, so I feel like it should be okay. So moving into the next month, because I'm doing these kind of like around the 15th, so it'll be from now, March 15th through around April 15th. I'm excited. I have quite a few lip products and quite a few eyeshadows, but I feel good about that. I feel like with the eyeshadows, even though I have quite a few in this project, I feel like they all can be used almost on a daily basis. They are kind of utility shades for me. I have an inner corner shade, I have a liner shade, I have a lid setting shade, and then I just have like one bonus, that cinder, that I can use again on my lower lash line and the outer third all over the lid. I just feel like the shades that I have selected are easy. I'm just excited to keep on working through these items. So I would love to hear from you how the past month has gone for you and your project pans. Let me know down below what types of project pans you're doing. Is it a rolling style? Are you doing anything that, you know, is kind of different? I would love to know. I'm doing this project pan. I'm doing eyeshadow roulette, which is my twist on pan those eyeshadows. And then I'm also doing a project use it up, which is all non-makeup items. So like skincare, body care, hair care, things like that. So I'm going to stop rambling. Thank you guys for hanging out and taking some time out of your day to tune into this video. I really do appreciate it. And I'm going to see you guys in my next one. Take care.